Well, this is Barracuda Buzz, and boy, do we have a problem. The last thing to be done on painting the doors didn't go as planned. So I'm going to show you now the steps that I took to fix my fuck-ups. The way I set this up is I'm going to shoot the whole backside of this door skin. I got enough paint, I ain't worried about it. And I'm going to shoot up in here. So now everything's in color. I got the paint, everything else. Now when the doors, what we'll do is we'll flip them over and then we'll shoot the backside and I'll reach underneath with that paint gun and I'll shoot this lip all the way around on these doors. So as we can see here, there's a lip right there. We're going to tape on this side of that lip right along it to leave that edge, tape edge right there. And we are going to paint, then we paint this outside door skin here. We're gonna shoot underneath and paint all the way up into here too, over again. So this edge here is gonna be really nice. Well, as you can see, what I did was I taped all along where this lip is. Focus in a little bit so you can see exactly. So this lip here, we got the tape edge all the way along that. So now what's going to happen is when we paint, like I was saying, we're going to paint not only this main skin area, but overlap it so this edge will have a full wet coat. You can see, went down this whole edge, and I just put some pinstripe tape to get in there. From here, we will mask off this whole backside area, this whole side. So now when we're spraying this side and this into this edge, all this is gonna be masked and covered, all our work that we've done on these jams.
Well, this is the way I taped it. I ended up taping it. Over masking over everything so nothing gets inside, because I had problems with overspray getting inside. If you don't get it every nook and cranny, like the trunk, if you watch my videos on the trunk or the engine compartment, they had overspray from shooting the car. It wasn't masked off enough. So this is masked where all your majority of your large area holes that can get into this jam area where we painted isn't gonna get in there. So you don't want to overspray in there. But as you can see, this is the way on the lips, nice and even cut with the blade as well in certain areas, so it'll be a nice sharp edge when we peel that tape off, and it will be on the inside, which will be not noticeable. So now we're ready to spray. Well, to wet sand, and we will wet sand these outer shells as we flip these doors, and then spray. Getting ready to put a coat of sealer on, and then we'll put a coat of the color on after that. But we gotta push down this tape and make sure, especially on these ends, these doors, the tops don't matter because we're not doing that, and you got strips that come in here. But these doors here, these ends, you know, you got the hinge side, and then you got the door side, the open side. That open side is crucial, but you wanna get both sides and make sure that you're opening up that tape nice and tight back up against there because it was folded. Now, I don't know the tricks of taping for that bending not to occur. So, if you know it, shoot me a feedback back on that, because I'm using half-inch tape and I'm still having issues with it rolling back on me.
The last thing to be painted? Fucking A. Something has to go wrong, right? Well, we're in the early stages with one coat of color on these doors. And what do I run in? I run into fucking pinholes. Pinholes, man. That I missed blocking. That's why it's important to fucking block twice. And guide coat. Use guide coat. So, it's my mistake. I did it. And I seen part of it before, and I ignored the problem because I didn't think it was going to be that big of a deal. I thought it was on the lower part. The lower edge by the rocker panel area. Well, that's not the case. It's in the middle of the fucking door, too. I have to fucking fix it. The other door is fine. Nothing's wrong. This door, pinholes. From what? There was severe damage. This was concaved in and rotted out. I had to repair all this sheet metal in this part of the door, in this whole area of the door, in this contour. So when I did mud, I bondo glass, whatever. You gotta be careful with the pinholes. I should have caught it blocking, but I didn't. So I went down to the sealer for the most part. Had to feather out this anyways area, so I didn't have to use any filler there. Filled the pinholes with a metal glaze, just filled the pinholes, and as soon as that dries in about a half hour, I'm gonna go with 320 grit dry and sand this down. Then, within about a half hour after that, I think I'm gonna wait an hour total, I'm gonna shoot urethane primer blocking and re-block this whole area. And we have two spots over here that were from little pieces of dirt or fuzz that came into the sealer. So I'm gonna shoot that with primer, just touch up that, feather all that primer surfacer in. Then I am gonna go over, I'm gonna wet sand everything down with 500. As you can see, body work is finally done on this repair job that we had to do. Everything's blocked down, the primer's blocked down, the edges are feathered, everything's all set. We're ready to shoot a coat of sealer on this as soon as it dries up, because I just got done wet sanding this and wet sanding that since it's sat. You got a 24 hour maximum period on this base coat, Deltron, before you have to rescuff it if you're gonna put on color back again or anything else, a sealer or whatever primer.
Well, we got a major malfunction here. And what that is after prepping this shit and getting that pinholes fixed up and blocking it down with wet sanding with 500, not blocking it, yeah, of course the primer, and then sanding, all that prep bullshit. You seen it. Then I spray on this coat of sealer, a nice medium wet coat, and guess what the fuck happens? Areas right in here where the paint met the primer that I put on, it wrinkled. It came up. Little spots over here. Little spots over there. So all these fucking little spots. Now I gotta sand this son of a bitch down and start over. This is starting to fucking suck!
Well, I sanded it down. I got all the wrinkles out as far as what I've seen. And I even took it down further in a lot of areas. You know, I go around and look and stuff like that. But the true test will be when I put the first coat of primer on. Now, I'm going to use a primer surfacer, 2K primer, and re-block this. Well, not, I'm going to have to re-block it, but I'm going to go straight to 400. And then I'll wet sand with 5. Finish sand with 5. But that's what I had to go through from wrinkling that occurred in here and up there, as you've seen. And even over here on the edge and along this edge here. So let's just hope nothing else is wrinkling, but or wrinkles, because this is the problem, and this is what I was talking about. Your feather edge is color. You got to dust coat. You got to put a real thin layer on and let it bond, let it flash time, maybe 15 minutes. Go back, stick another coat on there, you know, and that's, a lot of guys will go straight to color with this. I'm not. I'm going to primer, and if I'm not happy with that, or if I break through the primer at all, I'm going to go and seal it too, because everything was sealed on this car. It has a dark gray sealer. This is the gray. You can see the light gray is the primer that I'm spraying on. It's a sandable primer. The dark gray is a sealer. It's a non-sandable primer. I mean, it could be sand, but it's not supposed to be sand, and it is a bitch. Let me tell you. I spent 45 minutes sanding this door down with the DA also, and that's as far as I could get. So, it absolutely sucks. Now, you gotta remember, there's a coat of the dark sealer underneath this red paint. Then there's one coat of red base. Then there's spot primed this, as we've seen before, with the light gray. Then a coat of the dark gray sealer over everything again. So, it is just filled with mills of fucking paint. So, what do we gotta do? Either gotta take it all the way down. I took it down to 240, and that was it. I wanna prime it, and then sand right to 4500.
Finally! Ready to shoot color on the doors. And it's the last thing to be painted on the Cuda. So let's go ahead and I'm gonna show you how I'm gonna reach down and spray that bottom lip that we've been talking about. It wasn't sprayed in sealer, just the metal, bare metal, and the primed areas were sprayed in sealer. That red that we sprayed when we did the jams is still on there. Let's knock it out. So we got these doors with three coats of base on, finally, with no issues. What I did was spot primed with DP sealer, no reducer, with an airbrush, and just dotted, spotted, just little spots that the when I wet sanded the primer, broke through to the color. Then I laid down a nice coat of DP sealer with reducer. Then I laid down three coats of color. It was like starting from scratch. So now I'm gonna tack rag it. It's like hours later. So we're gonna tack rag it and spray three coats of clear on, since it's the outside shell, doors, and the body, fenders, hood, have all three coats of clear on. Finally done with the doors. Everything turned out. As you can see, got three coats of clear. The first coat was light, second coat was medium, third coat was medium wet. Went on nice, didn't have any issues. I'm gonna have to unmask everything on the bottom, which I taped, as you've seen, on the lip line, and see how that turned out. But besides that, I might have some touch-ups to do after wet sanding, but that's it. I gotta wheel out, just one little run on the mirror, and she's done, finally. After all fucking summer of painting, the Cuda